Well, it looks like the DNA test results are in. Your man, Stevie J, is in fact the father of Jocelyn Hernandez's baby. I know. Let me go ahead and read to you the title of this TMZ story. It's titled, Stevie J, I've got DNA results. I'm the father. Thank you, TMZ, for posting this story on December 19th of 2016. Let me go ahead and read to you what TMZ had to say about it all. TMZ writes, Stevie J did it without Maury Povich, unfortunately. And he's confirmed. He is the father of the baby Jocelyn Hernandez is squeezing out within the next month. Stevie's DNA test results showed he indeed did the deed, according to new docs he filed, and now that he knows, he's asking for visitation rights, but also for primary physical custody. Doesn't make sense, but maybe he's covering all his bases. Jocelyn's due January 9th, and in the docs, he says he absolutely wants to be in the delivery room. Stevie's repeating his request for Jocelyn to be drug tested because he claims she abused drugs and alcohol throughout her pregnancy and fears this affected the fetus. He wants the infant drug tested within 24 hours of birth. The docs include a text message he says came from Jocelyn, quote, you will never see your fucking daughter. This is not going to be a smooth birth, no matter what happens in the delivery room. Thank you very much, TMZ, for that tea. So what I have to say about it, this is getting really messy real quick. He wants to see that coochie one more time when that baby comes out, and he wants the baby to be tested immediately. Nah, let me stop. I'm just being stupid. No, but seriously, all jokes aside, man, this is terrible. El terrible. This is why, look, if you know that you should not be having a child with somebody, don't have sex with that person. Make sure there's some birth control, some condoms, some something going on. Well, definitely condoms for sure. Make sure you're taking, quote, preventative measures. Because, I mean, she could have just as easily killed that baby. I mean, she did it on, what was it, season 1 of Love & Hip Hop Atlanta? You know? Stevie basically let her know, you killed this baby, your ass is going back to the strip club. Remember that? I still remember that. I mean, if that's true. I don't know whether or not that was just a storyline, though. Maybe it was reenacted, maybe it was fake, I don't know. But allegedly, he nudged her, pushed her to kill that baby. Now, if she really did do that, she did not have to. She could have done something else. What's the worst that he could have done? Kicked her off the show? Did he really have that much juice in season one? I seriously doubt that for anybody who would say, well, he would have gotten her off the show and then she would have been living on the streets. I don't think so for some reason. I don't think the baddest puta, as much of a hustler as she is, I don't think she would ever let that happen to herself. At least not in recent times. But anyways, if you knew good and damn well that this man wanted you to have an abortion before, allegedly, why would you not take preventative measures to make sure that you do, rather to ensure that you don't get pregnant ever again by him? The relationship was volatile from the beginning. When have they ever been on good terms? It's like, you gotta be kidding me. But I have to ask this question. Who do you think the baby should be with? Jocelyn? Stevie, or both? Let me know what you think about it all below. Be sure to subscribe to the Meat Magazine YouTube channel. So visit meatmagazine.blogspot.com for more. Follow me on Twitter at Meat Magazine, Meat Magazine 7 on Google Plus, and Meat Magazine blog on Instagram.